anybody? Okay, Dr. Rogers, you're here. Yeah, this job.
Okay, let's begin. I want to start with a brief story that happened in my life. 2 years ago, I was witness one of the heart-touching events of my life with my father. My sister had a problem, had a health problem, and doctors couldn't anything in Baku. Therefore, my father decided to take her to Tabriz, Iran. I and my father left the hospital to buy something for eating. And when we approached Tabriz Square, there was a gallows which surrounded by a huge crowd. And I asked my father, I had never seen that gallows before, except in televisions. I asked my father, what was that gallows for? My father answered that probably they were going to hang a rapist. I was shocked, thanked, because I never saw such a situation, and I knew that in our country from 1990s, hanging people or capital punishment was abolished. Capital punishment was abolished. After that day, I started to think about it. Is it capital punishment? Is it true way of punishing people? I read so many books. I looked statistics. I read a lot of arguments by critics. Then I decided that capital punishment must be applied. There are some critics who argue that criminals have also a right to live, and maybe one day they will realize their guilt. But it is very difficult to feel which feelings does victims have. And most of the cases, which is related to rape or murder, families of victims are not satisfied just by imprisonment. Now, I want you just imagine that one man rapes and murders another woman, then go to a prison, have a three times a day a meal, and live his life just like other criminals, such as thieves. Could you imagine that feelings? And also simultaneously, could you imagine the family? Could you imagine the victims of families feelings, how they feel? Of course, it is very difficult to think like them, because we have never witnessed such situations. But if one person steals others' life, why is that one wouldn't pay for it with his or her life? Nobody has the right to kill or rape another people. The next point I want to mention is that the death penalty also is good for society as a type of state, because a lot of people after death penalty, they will realize that if I kill or rape somebody, it will pay for my life. And also capital punishment reduces crime rate. According to Financial Tribune, the rate of criminal activity in Iran has decreased by 5%, compared to previous year, said police deputy for crime, Arjan Hazizade. Iran, as an applier of capital punishment, should be an example for all world's countries. In conclusion, if someone kills another one, he or she has to pay by his or her life. If someone rapes woman, that person has no place in our society. When it comes to us to think about capital punishment, is it a true way of punishing or not? My advice is for you, just try to put yourself into shoes of victims or families of victims. Thank you for your attention.